Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make an Etsy cover image using Canva, which is free. And I'll be showing you two different ways. One, if you don't have a logo already created, and then one if you do. Now, I also want to mention, if you haven't yet signed up for an Etsy shop, there's a link in my description below where you can get 40 free listings. And if you use that, I also get 40 free listings. So it's sort of a win-win situation. All right, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing we'll want to do is just Google Etsy cover image size. And the reason we want to do this first is because sometimes Etsy changes things and we want to make sure we're getting the right size, of course. Okay, so this says 1200 by 300 is the right size, but if you look down here, you can also see that there's a larger size if you want to go that route, 3360 by 840. Now, Canva only has one of these sizes, 1200 by 300, but you can always create a new Canva document in the larger size. For this tutorial, though, we'll just do the 1200 by 300. All right, so let's go ahead and head on over to canva.com. And you'll need to start an account if you don't already have one, and that's free. It's just a matter of signing up like you would with any other account. I'm going to come up here to the search and type in Etsy, and it'll give us some options of what we can create. So I'm going to go with Etsy shop cover. We'll click on that. And then here are a bunch of templates that we can use to create our Etsy shop cover. Now, usually I like to have my shop name on my cover photo. My new Etsy shop is going to be called Lark and Cedar. And it's a fake shop, I just made that name up. But I kind of want an earthy look because that's what I think of when I think of those words, lark and cedar. So I'm gonna scroll down and look for something a little earthy. I'm really liking this one with the wood. So I'll click on that one and it'll open a new screen. Now I can just click on this, and if I double click, I can get in and highlight the words that are there. I'm just going to type lark and cedar. Now I think this could probably look nice with white text. So I'm going to highlight all the text and I'll come up here to this little A with an underline, which is my text color. And I'm going to change this to just white. I think I'm going to add a little subtitle. We'll just type digital designs. To select all of it, I'm hitting Command A or Control A on a PC. So I'll change that too. I'm going to position my mouse so that I get the little four arrows. And then I'm going to move this down. You might have to be right on the edge for that to work. Then I'll hold shift and select both of them. And I'll use my arrow keys and my shift button to move it up so that it's more centered. Okay, now I think it might be nice to put a little line between these. So I'm going to come over here to my elements. And I'll just choose this line right here. And it just adds it for me. I'm going to get on the edges and I'm holding option to resize from both sides. And I'm holding shift to keep it straight. That looks pretty good. Now I'm going to change the color, which is right up here. I think we'll do white for this too. And now I'll move that down a little bit. I'm going to select both of these again, holding shift. I'm going to move them over so they're a little more centered over that line. Okay, and I'm really liking the way this looks, but I think I want to add a little pop of color in here. So I'm going to get my triangle, which is right over here. I'll click that. My brand color for my new fake Etsy shop is going to be teal. So I'm just going to click this color up here and I'm going to change this to this teal color, dark turquoise. And now I'm going to make this a lot bigger. All right, that looks pretty good. Now, as you can see, it's going over the text, so we want to send it to the back. And to do that, we can come up here to position. And we'll just go backward, 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 until it goes behind the text. And I also want to make this kind of see-through so I can still get some of that texture of the wood through it. So I'm going to click on the transparency right here, and I'll just change this to, I'm thinking about 64. That looks nice. Okay, so this is the first design, and this is pretty much good to go. So we can go ahead and download this and upload to our Etsy shop. So I'll click download. And it's going to suggest a PNG, and that's fine, so we'll say download. And if you're on Chrome, you'll see it come right down here. If you're on Safari, it might be up here or something like that. But we can click this caret and choose Show in Finder. And if we hit our spacebar on a Mac, we can preview this. And here is our design ready to go onto Etsy. So let's go to Etsy.com. So you'll come up here to your shop manager and click that. And I don't have this set up. But down over here along this edge will be an orange button that says your shop name. So you'll want to click that, and then up at the top you'll see Edit Shop with a black button. You'll want to click that, and then at the very top there'll be like a dotted line with a pencil shape up here, and you can click that and add in your cover photo. And that's it. Okay, so let's do the second style. This one is going to use my logo, and I'll use a white version of it. Now, if you need a logo created for you, you can actually hire a logo designer on Etsy or Upwork or other sites like that. And I also have tutorials here on my channel showing a few ways to create a logo design, but you're going to need access to Adobe Illustrator for those. Okay, so let's go back, and we'll go back and type Etsy shop again. We'll choose Etsy shop cover, and this time I think I'm going to use this brands and trends one. Now, I like this photo, but I think I want something that looks more like pine trees or something like that for the cedar part of Larkin Cedar. So I'm going to come over here to photos, and I'm just going to search for trees over here. Okay, we have a lot of pretty options. I'm going to choose this photo, and it puts it right over top of the other one. We can just double click this one and delete it by hitting delete on our keyboard. And then I'm just going to grab a corner and make this one a lot bigger. Now it might go off the edge, and that's just fine. I'm going to move it up just a little bit. I think I want to add kind of a color overlay on this. So what we can do is just go up to effects, and I'm going to scroll down a little bit. I'm going to add a duotone. I'm really liking this peppermint one here. Now I'm going to click on this text, and I'll just delete it by hitting delete on my keyboard. And now I'm going to upload my own logo. So I'll come over here to uploads, and you can see it right here, but I'm going to go ahead and upload media so you can see how to do this. Then we'll choose our device. Then you can just navigate to wherever it is. And mine is right here. I've got a black one and a white one. And I want to use the white one. So we'll open that. It'll take a moment to save there. Then I'll click on this and it'll just add it to my canvas. And now I can resize it. We can also click position and center to make sure it's in the center of the screen. And that's it. Now I'm ready to download this one. So I can download here, and we'll choose download. So then to get it into your Etsy shop is the same process as before. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, please hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.